to North Brentwood.
We are a Bible-based, family-focused, and multi-generational congregation.
Our focus is ministry forward.
Here are your ministry highlights.
Good morning and happy Resurrection Sunday. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm Reverend Kim, and I am so happy to be here with...
me, BJ Proctor. Happy Easter!
Today, we welcome gospel music star Vanessa R. Williams of Richard Smallwood's group Vision as our guest psalmist. And to celebrate the joy of our risen Savior, our arts ministries have been working for weeks to share a special Easter presentation titled When Jesus Speaks, which was written by some of FBCNB's own young adults like PJ here. Want to hear more about it? I will give you a quick overview and a special announcement a little later in our service. On another note, have you heard? Masks are now optional at FBCNB, so we hope to see you in person really soon.
Do you have great news to share about your children and youth? We'd love to hear it. Send 3 to 5 sentences with the name of your young person and who, what, when, where, and why of their accomplishments by Monday, April 17th. We will share them on Youth Sunday, which is April 30th. Send the good news about your young person to inbox at fbcnbmd.net or bring them to the church office. Speaking of Youth Sunday, our preacher for the day will be our own Miss Jordan Loving. Let's keep her and all our youth in prayer as they prepare to lead us in worship on April 30th. On Wednesday, Bible studies return this week. Bible Talk will be at 11:30 a.m. on Zoom instead of at the church. And Life Application Bible Study will meet at 6:45 p.m. on Zoom.
Now it's giving time. We have several secure and quick ways for you to share your offering. Go to fbcofnb.org and click Give on the top banner. You can also text your offering to 301-321-7747. Or in Cash App, just enter $FBCofNB to select our account. Be sure to include your full name in the notes section so that we can make sure you get credit for your contribution. Another option is to search for First Baptist Church of North Brentwood on the Givelify app. And if you prefer to mail your offering, send it to 4000 Wallace Road, North Brentwood, Maryland, 20722. Thank you in advance for sharing your gift. The church office will be closed this week for spring sabbatical, but our virtual activities will still take place. Let's all reflect, refresh, and be renewed for greater ministry moving forward.
Stay safe and stay connected to the web and social media sites of the First Baptist Church Incorporated. We're impacting lives and growing disciples.
Good morning, First Baptist Church of North Brentwood. Hold on, I know we can do better than that. Good morning, First Baptist Church of North Brentwood. Now I know we can do better than that, for he rose for us. Good morning, First Baptist Church of North Brentwood. Thank you so much for being here. I am so excited to be here, for he rose for us. So we will praise him for who he is, for what he has done, what he's doing right now, and what he's going to do for us in the future. Amen. Amen. For God is the only God. He is the most magnificent God. For John 3:16 says, for God loves the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Amen. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? So as we are going through our service today, and as we are praising our Lord and Savior, for today is Resurrection Sunday, I want you to always remember that Jesus paid it all. He got on that cross on Good Friday, and he paid it all just because he loves us. Now, I don't know. I think that's more love than I could ever give. But he was the one, and on the third day, he rose with all power in his hands, and he sits at the right hand of God. For Jesus paid all our sins, Jesus has paid all of the feeling of loneliness, the feeling of our past mistakes. He paid it all, for the wages of sin is death. But God, having God is for eternal life. Amen? Amen? Amen. So as we prepare to set the atmosphere, I want you to always remember that you are here for a reason. Whatever, if you need a blessing, if you need prayer, or if you just need to give God the praise for being here in this spot today, know that He is here. He's here working right now. He is here working right now. Amen. Amen. So let me tell you right now that you are in for a treat today. All right. And don't block your blessings. Amen. Amen. So let's prepare to set the atmosphere with our music ministry.
Praise the Lord, First Baptist. Praise the Lord, First Baptist. Is anybody in here excited about the risen Savior? I said, is anybody excited about our Lord of Lords and King of Kings, who died and rose again? Jesus reigns. Hallelujah.
him. No one can kill him. No one can dethrone him. He reigns. No one can beat him. No one can kill him. No one can dethrone him.
Hallelujah.
Filled with praise for your name. Good Friday was messy, Lord, because they brutally murdered your son. Saturday was a day of mourning as your son lay in that tomb. But my God, this morning we come to you happy and rejoicing because he rose. He rose. Death could not hold him down in that tomb. And we are here today, God, because you selfishly gave of your son for us, for all of us, so that we may live. And we cannot thank you enough for that. So we come to you this morning with hearts filled with praise, with hearts filled with worship for you. You are here with us this morning. But you're here with us every day. We thank you. We ask you to continue to be with our disciples this morning, with our arts ministry as they preach your word today through the arts. Be with each servant, Lord, as they deliver their lines, as they run the audio board, as they run the video technician. Be with all of them as they present your preached word through their ministry. And we just thank you, Father God, for today, Resurrection Sunday. These things we pray in your Son, Jesus the Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you.
Happy Resurrection Sunday, FBC and B family and friends. I'm Reverend Kim. Our Arts Ministry's Easter presentation, When Jesus Speaks, which was written by some of FBC and B's own young adults, is just moments away. It's a coming-of-age story about a woman named Jade who is seeking to connect with Jesus on a more personal level. We will go along with Jade on her Christian walk and witness three stages in her life as a teen, as a college student, and as a young adult, and discover how in each stage she encounters Jesus. Now, let's welcome Reverend Dr. Janet P. Caldwell, the pastor of Congregational Care and Worship here at First Baptist Church of North Brentwood, as she sets the stage for what is sure to be a blessing.
Amen, amen, amen. Let's praise the Lord. Come on. He woke us up this morning and he started us on our way, and here we are together at this Resurrection Sunday service. Isn't God good? Isn't God good? 3 years ago, we didn't know that we would be here, but look, here we are in the sanctuary. We're on virtual space. We're on the phone just to praise him for another Resurrection Sunday. So I'm not going to be before you long. I just want to share with you that it has been the tradition of First Baptist to present, to offer to the congregation and to those who wish to be witnesses, that we would have presentation just to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. It's been our tradition. But back in 2019, our senior pastor, Pastor Kay, had a vision that we would involve our young adults even more so in the presentation, to allow them to take a leadership position. So it's by the grace of God that three young ladies came together to create, to develop, to write the script for a play entitled When Jesus Speaks. And I can't see out there, but if they're here this morning, I would like for them to stand. That's Taryn Levels, that's Courtney Lovett, that's Tracy Watkins. If they are here this morning, we'd like to just praise God for them. Praise God. I see you. I see you. Thank you so much. Thank you. In fact, we want to invite you to come on up here. Come on up here. Come on up front with us. There's the second row here that you can come on and sit with us. And so it was our pastor's vision that we would present that coming Palm Sunday in 2020. Well, you know what happened. You know what happened. The Lord allowed for a pandemic to come our way. And so I had to give them that fateful call to let them know that we're not going to be able to present. What? No, church has closed down. All the institutions had closed down. The places of worship had closed down in March. So we could not present it. But God is so good. How many of you know that God is good? How many of you really know that God is good? Because along the way, we've lost some folks. Along the way, we've lost jobs. Along the way, there were many losses. But look at God on today. Here we are, and it's only by his grace and his mercy. So back in January, here comes Pastor again. And he says, Reverend, I want you. He said, Reverend, I want you and Warren to pull together that script that was written back in 2019. I want you to pull some folks together. We're going to present it on Easter Sunday of this year. Well, you know my face. You know my face, my expressions, but it's all good. It's all good. So to God be the glory, because I did try to reach out to folks who were the original cast members, and many of them have gone on to college. Some have are raising families, and Lord, what am I going to do? Well, God showed me some people. He showed me some people, and I'm telling you, I promise you, he showed me some folks. And today, they are here. They have worked hard. They have prayed. and they're ready, they are willing, and they are able, because our God is a good God. So today, here we are. I've about gone crazy, but it's all good. Here we are, the cast, the media ministry, the music ministry, dance ministry, drama ministry, who have all pulled together to give God the glory. So I want you to just even now to stand up and praise God for those who will present with us this morning the sermon for the morning, When Jesus Speaks. You may be seated. So as is custom, before we preach a sermon, the minister, the preacher, will always say a prayer. So let us go to the Lord in prayer. Eternal God, our Father, it's once again that we come before you, before your people, to proclaim your word. We thank you, God, for Jesus the Christ, the one who sacrificed his life for each and every one of us. But it was on that third day that he got up. He got up with all power in his hands. So God, I pray right now that you will anoint all that is done on this morning, that someone who came here today, someone who is struggling, will recognize that there is a voice, the voice that comes from Jesus the Christ. So God, be in everything that we do, that you might get the glory out of it all. Feed us, Lord, bread of heaven, feed us until we want no more. So we give you glory, honor, and praise, and let the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. For Lord, we know that you are our strength and our redeemer. And we pray it all in Jesus' name. Let the church say, amen. God bless.
Can we teach you a little track? Come on, make some noise in here. Come on. Y'all ready? Help us sing this.
tell you about my crazy day.
You
Bob asked us to come into the office,
right.
Called us
I
in.
Know. Right.
Everybody didn't show up, and then he decided to do a Zoom meeting. Who does that?
Stuff like that, always that.
I could have stayed home.
I'm starving, hungry.
Oh, my goodness. I'm sorry, babe. I didn't ask you about your day.
Now you're going to ask me.
I'm going to ask you now. How was your
day? It was good. It was good. I'm really busy today, but, you know, I didn't get a chance to eat lunch. I was trying to get some lunch. This pizza looks good.
And I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to cook.
Oh, that's okay.
Okay. This will be good.
Where is she at now? I'm ready to eat.
Where's that girl?
I done called her a couple of times. Let me see.
Call her again.
It is hot. Ready? Yeah. Baby girl, come eat. Oh, I swear, this is so good.
That does look good.
Yeah, Put that right there.
Sweetheart, will you put that phone down and come and eat, please?
Coming.
Why don't you stay off of that phone all the time?
Hey, fam.
We're so glad you could join us.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yes, we'll put it right there. Put that piece right over there, and then we can eat that part.
Okay.
Whew. Mm. Thanks, baby girl. Lead us in prayer.
God is great. God is good. Let us thank him for this food. Amen.
Really? Baby girl, really? Man, Jesus didn't even recite a prayer that fast. If I knew you was going to recite a prayer at a speed of light like that, I wouldn't even bother to close my eyes.
It took you a minute to get downstairs. Is everything okay?
Eh, it will be. I had to fuse a situation in the group chat. Oh.
A group what? A group what?
Mom, you need to get Dad hip to the game.
Listen, sweetheart, you know your father is a little seasoned, so you're gonna have to explain this one to him.
Dad, a group chat is just a way for people to text more than one person at a time.
So what happened in that group chat?
Well, Reggie's upset that Kayla and I have been so busy studying for these exams so we hadn't had enough time to spend together. I keep telling him, though, that starting next year, we'll be at Howard together for the next 4 years. Besides, I'll see them on Thursday for our movie night.
Thursday? No, not this Thursday. You've got choir rehearsal. Remember, and I signed you up for the opening prayer.
Which you might need a little practice on, the way you just fled through grace like that.
But we meet at the church twice this week already, not including Sunday service. I just want some time with my friends.
And you will have time with your friends. They're just going to be your friends from church.
But
nothing. You heard what I said.
That's right.
This is not up for discussion. You just tell your little friends that you will see them some other time.
No, she.
Marcus!
Dear, I don't just.
Did you see what she just did?
I saw what she just did.
I think your daughter's trying.
No, listen, dear.
You know what?
No.
Are you going to get her or shall I?
No, give her. She'll come around.
She is not too old.
Told you,
for this.
All
give
these
me,
kids
let
get
go
upset.
Me.
I take a high blood pressure medicine, and all my stuff is going away.
Thank you.
They make me so mad sometimes. Jesus, I don't get it. I do everything right. I go to school, I do my chores, I do my homework, I study day in and day out for my exams. I'm respectful. Why don't they ever care about things that I want?
Well, you know, their parents,
I mean, I'm 17 years old. I know kids who make life so much worse for their parents. Why are they always pressing me?
They care about
you. I mean, sign me for the church school opening prayer without even asking? I already have a great relationship with you. I know who you are. We talk all the time.
You're the one who does most of the talking.
I'm active in the youth ministry. I'm on the praise team. I'm present every single Sunday. What more could they possibly want from me? I have a life too, and it just seems as if they're doing everything in their power not to let me live it. Whatever. It'll be different this time next year when I'm packed and out of here. Until then, I'll figure things out. Thanks, Jesus.
Wait, we haven't even had a...
That's all right. As you grow, you'll learn to hear from me.
There's a voice that cries out in the silence. It's searching for a heart that will love him. Longing for a child who will give him their all, give it all. He wants it all. And there's a God who walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate. Longing for a child who will give him their all, give it all. He wants it all. And he says, love me. Love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today. Serve me. Serve me with your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down. Let go of your idols. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. So give it all. There's a God who treads over the earth, searching for a heart that is desperate, longing for a child who will give him their all, give it all. He wants it all, and he says, love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today. Serve me. Your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down. Let go of your idols. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all of you, all of you. He wants it all. It all today, surrender all. There's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child who will give him their all, give it all. He wants it all.
Thank you. This is a beautiful dorm. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. This is where all our money is going. Oh, well, we're gonna make it nice then, right? Okay, what do you wanna do? Put your suitcase down and we'll put this on your bed. Just to, okay, yes, let's do that. Thing. What do you wanna do?
And I already have some posters.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You can get some posters and let's do this.
This is too much for me. This is way too much for me. I can't get y'all just walking in here. We got to get all this stuff up. Everybody around here got up. You know, I'm tired of this. No, I'm tired. Huh? Where do you want to put this at?
Put that down. Put that over there.
I'm coming over there.
Slowly.
Yeah, you know. Oh. We should have paid somebody to do this. I'm not doing this no more. Say that right now. Hold on. Put it down right. I'm going to put it down right here. Okay.
You okay?
That's it.
All right.
That's it. Everything's off the truck. That's all of it.
Ooh, you know what?
Woo.
We should make this real comfortable because Mama might want to come for a weekend and come and see you.
That's good, isn't it?
No, we got a lot of work to do.
Yeah, put it right over there.
We got a lot of work to do.
No.
All right.
We.
Yeah, we.
I have a whole lot to do.
But you know what? Marcus, this just got real.
Yeah.
This is for real. Our baby girl,
yeah,
all grown up and in college now.
Oh, Mom, I'll be home before you know it.
I know, but still.
You guys are only 30 minutes away.
That's right. That's right. And I'll be up there in 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Don't make me get a speed ticket now, okay?
You don't need my help with that. Hello, my name is Taylor, and I'm your roommate. You must be Jay.
Man, what is she? Man, she know. That was rude.
We are Jay's parents.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you. Jay, who are you texting? Yeah. Is that Reggie and Kayla? You know what? I really am going to miss those two.
Mm-mm, that mean. I'm gonna, they come in here eating up all my food. All
well,
I ain't going to miss
them. We love them. Nope.
Yeah, it's them. I have to go to freshman orientation.
Already?
Wow.
Yes. It starts in 10 minutes. I just came back in the room to look for something. Did you want to go together? Well, I was supposed to meet with my friends, so.
Jay, be so rude.
Yes.
We taught you better than that.
Way better than that.
She'd be delighted to go.
Okay.
Yes, yes. Okay. We got everything. All right. Jay, do you have your keys?
Yes, Mom.
What about your ID?
Mom, I got this.
Okay, we just want to be sure. Right, Marcus?
Right,
Marcus!
Yeah! Yeah.
Marcus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah!
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, oh, yeah.
Don't interrupt him, Mom. He's too busy fantasizing what my room's gonna turn into.
Well, at least she knows.
You're about to be late. Ain't nothing new, Kayla. You know she's always the last one. Hey, Mr. and Mrs. Williams.
Hey, babies!
Sorry, y'all. Okay, love you guys. Bye.
Hey, you have to say bye.
Bye.
Bye, that's it.
I'm gonna miss you guys.
We're gonna miss you too, kiddo.
We're gonna miss you.
You know what, hon? We want you to do well, but have a little fun too, okay?
Oh, but not too much. Not too much. Because I tell you this, don't make me have to come up here, you know, knock those boys out. I tell you that. I'll be right at your doorstep right in a heartbeat.
Well,
I know, Dad, you said that. Love you guys. Bye.
Bye, baby.
She's okay.
You know what? Maybe we should. We can sit in the back. She won't even know we're there.
Let her grow up, honey.
Come
it's
on.
Okay, dear. Let her.
Well, that's my baby, though.
I know, but
that's
let
my
her
baby.
Go. It's okay, man.
Oh,
it's all right.
Okay, okay, all right, all right.
It's all right.
And now, it is 3 years later, as we find Jade in her junior year at Howard University, HU. Yes, it's 3 years later now. My, how time flies. Well, she's had some time to grow and develop from the cute little carefree teen to a sophisticated third-year student. You go, girl. And so here we find Jade in her beautiful dorm room, trying to study for her upcoming exams. She's having such a hard time trying to get it all together. Well, her concentration is off, her focus is off. How will she ever get through this most difficult time in her college career? Well, let's sit back, let's relax, and let us see what happens to Jade as she tries to study for her upcoming exams. And now it is.
Geez, you think that by now in my junior year, I have this stuff down packed.
Hi, sweetheart. I know you're busy at this time, but I just wanted to let you know that there's a Maundy Thursday service tonight at church, and it's streaming live so you can watch it from your room.
I can't. Exam tomorrow.
Hey there. We haven't talked in a while.
Hey guys. It's been a while since we hung out. Movie night? Like old times?
Can't. Going out with the Sorors tonight.
Again? This is the fifth time. She's so fake.
Y'all, I need a distraction.
Hey, hon, we'll be right over.
Everything all right?
Come in. Jeez, y'all, that was fast.
Hey, girl, we was right around the corner anyways.
Where are y'all going?
Oh, to this place around the corner. My girl said it was on point.
Let's go, sis. You said you needed a distraction anyway.
Yeah, this studying has had my head spinning. I'm frustrated and over it.
That's even more of a reason to go. You need a drink to relax.
Or a man.
Whatever. Wait. I don't have anything to wear this time.
It's okay. I have cute clothes back at my place. We can get dressed there.
True. Let's go then. But wait, maybe I should stick this one out and study.
You texted us. That means you need this, so.
Okay, wow. Maybe just one drink, but just one.
Girl, we got you. We'll only be out for a few hours, and then you'll have tomorrow morning to study.
And we'll get you a boo when we're out, too.
Y'all are a mess. I'll meet you outside. I have to grab a few things.
Don't keep us waiting now.
What are you doing? You have an exam to study for.
I know.
Going to that party, that wouldn't be a wise move.
Look, Jesus, I don't feel like arguing right now. Let me just do me. I'm sorry. I just need something to get my mind off things.
Good job.
I want y'all to make some noise, kiddo. One more time. So I love you so much. Oh, you're spoiling me now. You're spoiling me, y'all. I'm gonna start off easy. You're so breezy. I'm gonna start off easy, y'all. A little bit loud. Oh, I love you so much. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Tell you nothing but the truth. You're looking out of you to hold what you got. This is your spot. Do it like you want it because we love you a lot. Special shout going out to all the lovely young ladies. We got some dynamite horn players up here. We gonna let them warm up for you in a minute. You ready? Oh yeah, y'all been ready.
Drink this.
Oh, come on. He's got a cute friend, too.
Is this the guy that kept giving you drinks, Jay?
Maybe, but it's no big deal.
Are you kidding me? No big deal? He could have put anything in your drink. You need to be more careful.
Shh. Could you stop yelling? I have a headache.
No, I cannot stop yelling. I'm tired of this. This is the fifth time I've had to come get you from some party at God knows where.
You know, you really sound like my mother right now.
I'm not joking around with you right now, Jade. This is a serious matter. Those girls you party with, they're not your real friends if they leave you alone like this. Hey, they're toxic.
Hey, I have fun with them.
And all this fun, it's not good for you. Look at yourself. You used to be a straight A student and now you're falling behind in everything.
Whatever.
Look, I know you've been through a lot, but you have to get it together. And I know you're hurting, but there's still people that care for you.
What, like you? If I'm such a pain, then why don't you just abandon me like Kayla and Reggie did?
You know what? I just can't with you right now. Here, take this phone. I'll check up on you a little later, I guess.
Don't you worry, you don't have to cry, 'cause she knows just what you're going through. God is willing and he's able. This did not catch him by surprise. So just trust him and just step aside. Be still and don't question it. These obstacles, they were just.
Why is my life like this? Why does it have to be so hard? Why, Jesus? How could you just let Kayla and Reggie abandon me? How could you allow this to happen? Don't you have anything to say?
Are you gonna listen when I speak?
Yes.
I know what you're going through.
How? You're perfect and you don't sin. You know everything. How can someone like that ever understand?
Child, how much have you had to drink? Don't you remember anything that you learned in Sunday school? I was always being betrayed. Some of my closest friends turned their backs on me. Judas sold me out for money. Thomas doubted me. My enemies were constantly plotting. It felt like the whole world was against me. But what probably hurt the most was Peter. He denied me 3 times.
Hurt? But you're God. You can do whatever you want. You have all the power.
Yes, but it still hurts. It hurts me to see others in pain. It hurts me when my friends betray me, and it hurts me to see you like this. Don't you know that you're not alone, that I'm always with you?
But I always feel so alone. That's because,
you never talk to me. If you would just get down on your knees and pray, if you would just call on me, I would be right there by your side. Just trust me that I'll show you the right way. Just lean on me, and I'll take care of the rest.
Okay, I'm sorry.
That's all right. Everybody does it.
The truth can hurt you. Or the truth can change you. What will truth do to you?
I just wanna be happy. But if I keep on doing the things that keep on bringing me pain, there's no one else I can blame if I'm not happy. Wasted time, but now I can see the biggest enemy, it was me. So I'm not happy. Cry yourself to sleep. Shout and raise your hands. It won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
Preach.
If you're tired of being the same, if you're tired of things not changing, it's time for you to get out your way. Don't get stuck in how you feel. Say, Jesus, take the wheel. He knows the road that you need to take.
But it only works if
you wanna be happy.
Look at yourself and say,
don't you wanna be happy?
Yeah.
I just wanna be happy. But if I keep on giving my heart for people to tear apart, the healing will never start. So I can be happy.
Yes, Lord.
Will I ever be happy? Cry yourself to sleep. Shout and raise your hands. It won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
If I'm talking to you, then say,
if you're tired of being the same, if you're tired of things not changing, it's time for you to get out your way.
You've been there too long.
Don't get stuck in how you feel. Say, Jesus.
This day has finally come. Woo! You see all these people that come see our baby graduate.
How do I look?
Don't make too much noise.
When do I make too much noise?
They have rooms.
I'm here for my baby.
They have rooms.
I know they have rooms. I'm here. I'm good.
Thompson. Reggie James. Taylor Brown.
Thank you.
summa cum laude, Jade Williams!
Yo, come on. Let's get some pictures.
I'm
so proud. Everybody say cheese.
Yeah.
All right, Mama
got
to get in the
kitchen. Yeah.
Come on now.
Come on.
Got to get
Mama
now.
All right.
My arms
are
too short.
There we go. Y'all ready to eat something? Yes. Oh, y'all want what's that one to eat?
McDonald's. We should go to McDonald's.
Look, it doesn't matter where we go. Marcus is paying. Oh!
Boy, the stuff I get myself into,
trying to convince her loving parents that she was old enough to make her own life decisions, to being challenged by the rigors of the collegiate life, including the management of her time, like studying for exams or partying, but also to recognizing that everyone who claims to be your friend is not really looking out for your good. And then to discover that out of all of the folks you hang with and seem to be your friends, they're not really your friends at all. But thanks be to God, that God always has a ram in the bush. She found out that she did have one true friend. In this case, that friend was Taylor. Taylor was one who would not only be honest with Jade, but one who would also remain with her through thick and thin. And although Jade has had to transition through several life changes, not only was Taylor the true friend that she needed, not only were her parents a constant force of support for her, but more importantly, Jesus was always there for her as a friend like no other. Think about your own life as you have navigated from one transition to another. You can say with absolute confidence that I know that Jesus was with me each and every time. Well, keep your ears and eyes open to see what additional treasures God has in store for Jade and how she will recognize who the really important people are in her life.
Marcus, are you okay?
I'm at it again.
Come on.
I'm at it again.
You know what? I don't know why you didn't just pay the extra money and have somebody bring that in here and set it up.
You should have had
somebody
pay the last
time. Always trying to do stuff, you know.
No, I got my TV. I've been waiting to get this TV, get them kids out the house. Hold on, I got to figure out where I'm going to put it at, though. Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, finally get to put this up. I've been waiting to put this up since she been gone.
Do you think you could have gotten a bigger one?
No, yes,
was that
I could.
The biggest one you could find?
Oh, no, that one. Oh, okay. Let me see what it looked like.
Oh, Lord.
What it looked like? What it looked like? Ha! What it looked like? That's what I'm talking about. I've been waiting for.
You know, woo! I would rather have had a new refrigerator.
I've been looking for that for a while,
you know?
Huh?
Ooh, I can't imagine what football season's gonna sound like.
Oh, I know.
Oh, boys and their toys.
You see that, right? Okay, so Dad, wasn't that a TV in my room wasn't up for discussion when I lived here, but now there's a 60-inch in there.
That's the easy one, baby girl. You've been in my pockets for 18 years. 18 years, I can promise you that, but I can tell you this. That flat screen over there, that's my reparations. I'm gonna tell you that. Yep.
Oh, hush. Sweetheart, your father talks about you every day. And you know what? He secretly wishes you had moved back in after graduation.
Aw, Dad.
That's true, baby girl. You've taken all of my money. But you're the best thing that's ever happened to me. And I love you so much.
We do. Sweetheart, we are so proud of you. You have done everything that you set out to do.
Yes, you have.
You're a college graduate. You have an exciting job. You have a comfortable place to live.
Sure.
And most importantly, you live right down the street, so I get to spend every Sunday with my baby for church and dinner.
A free dinner, might I add.
It is dinner. Yeah.
Will you excuse me?
That you phone, know what? Some things never change.
All that phone.
What have I told you about that phone at the dinner table?
Sorry, Mom. I just went.
What is it? What's wrong?
I can't believe this. I thought my application ended up in somebody's junk folder.
Wait a minute, girl. You're making me anxious. What's going on?
Vogue. It's Vogue. A professor at Howard suggested that I apply almost a year ago. It's such a huge company, so I thought my application got lost. Their hiring manager just emailed me, offering me a position as a production assistant intern in New York City. New York City, I cannot believe this.
New York City? Wow, New York City. Wow, you love Vogue ever since you were really young. But I'm happy for you, I am happy for you.
Yeah, congratulations, baby.
Yes.
Wow.
I still can't believe this. This is the last thing I expected to happen to me, and in New York of all places? This is the chance of a lifetime, and now I get to live my dream. New York. That's actually pretty far away. That's actually the farthest I've ever been away from home. I mean, I feel like I just found my groove, you know? I have my family and a stable job. The timing couldn't be any more imperfect.
Sweetheart, your father and I have your back, and we always will.
Thank you again for dinner. Will you excuse me? I'm gonna go for a walk.
Sure, go.
Well, she was right about one thing. She did just get back, you know.
You know, that conversation got my blood pressure up.
I know.
This is just too sudden. This is way too sudden. New York?
Yes.
Marcus, we don't have any family in New York. Who's gonna take care of my baby? Who is gonna make sure that she is safe? And
when if she comes back calling me son? I'm not her son. I'm her dad.
Yes, you
know,
are.
this is sudden. And yes, we want the best for our baby girl.
Yeah.
But our faith is way bigger than our fear.
Yeah.
And we've taught her to value God. And what bigger faith could she have than entrusting his word for her? Because his plans for her are way, when I say way, they are way bigger than ours.
Yeah.
Okay? You gonna be all right?
I'm gonna be all
let's
right.
Let's go now. You're
gonna
be fine. You're gonna forget, hey, he got both of us.
But New York.
Be just fine. You know, I know.
Oh, so.
Hey girl, how's everything? I miss you.
I just talked to you 2 days ago.
I know, but it's not the same as walking to your room to bug you while you study.
I
You got that right. Speaking of adulthood, you will literally never guess what just happened to me. You remember that internship I applied for almost a year ago? I just heard from the hiring manager and I got the job. Well, I just told my parents about it, and they seemed shocked, but supportive. I could also tell they were nervous, too. I mean, I've never been so far away from them, and I don't know, what if I can't? Maybe you're right. Isn't it funny how quickly life moves? 30 minutes ago I was content, and now it feels like the weight of the world is on my shoulders. This is uncomfortable. I love you. I can do nothing without you, Father. I need you. Speak to me.
Speak to me, Lord.
remembered me.
It's funny. All my life, I heard my family and congregation say, cast your burdens on the Lord, but I never truly understood what they meant until now. I've been leaning on those in my life to give me direction about this decision, but the ones whose approval I need the most is yours. Lord, have you ever been faced with a difficult decision like this? Oh my gosh, you literally died for us. I can't even begin to imagine the pain that you must have felt.
I knew you'd catch on. The truth is, though, so many people have referenced my death on the cross as a primary source of my pain. They're right. It was a huge source of my physical pain. But I went through a painful experience even before that in the Garden of Gethsemane. I remember it like it was yesterday. I was agonizing in my spirit because I had to make the choice to choose to trust my Father's will, even though it would mean me suffering. And my death was imminent. I mean, Judas had already betrayed me, the soldiers were coming, and hey, at least you have friends and parents who support you and care for you, who want to guide you through this experience. But while I was agonizing, my friends were asleep, knocked out. And so, yeah, I've had to make some pretty tough decisions, but none that I would even begin to regret.
I can't even begin to tell you how thankful I am for you.
As I am for you. So please know that no matter where you go, no matter what you do, I will be here for you. As a result of my death and resurrection, there is no place in this world you can go without the guidance of my spirit. My spirit was with you at Howard. My spirit is with you here in Maryland. And my spirit will be with you in New York if that's what you decide. No matter what decision you make for your career, the most important decision is that you choose me. Seek me, just like you did. Just like you did a moment ago. And I'll be here with you. And when you look to the right or when you turn to the left, you'll hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way. Walk in it.
Home. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you. You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you.
You make me happy,
and you make me whole.
You make me whole.
You
praise God for all of our arts ministries. Glory to God when Jesus speaks. Praise his name. Now let us welcome our cast. First, our church, our administrators were Dr. Shannon and Dr. Edith Blackwell. Dr. Sandra Shannon and Dr. Edith Blackwell. Let's welcome them and thank them for their participation. Amen. Playing the role of party friends was Miss Zipporah Lewis, Miss Kennedy Carley, and Miss Tanya Mayo. Put your hands together for them. And now Jade's friends, Miss Cameron Holly and Mr. Benjamin Marshall. Welcome them. Let's keep it going. This is a lot. Praise God for their sacrifice. And now for her roommate, Miss Jada Loving. Welcome, Jada. Amen. And now playing the role of mom and dad, Miss Katrina Holloway and Mr. Tyrone Spears. And now, playing our lead role, Miss Sanaya Ubiera and Minister Micah K. as Jesus. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Fantastic. Praise his name. And again, our writers for today's presentation of When Jesus Speaks, Miss Courtney Loving, Miss Taryn Level, and Miss Tracy Watkins. Praise God for young adults. Praise God for young adults teaching us. Glory. Thank you, ladies. Giving God praise for you. And thank God for the best dance ministry in the world under the leadership of Miss Karen Thompson and Miss Cherie Jerry Sennard. Awesome. And praise God for our music ministry under the direction of Minister Warren K. Jones, featuring Miss Vanessa R. Williams. A special thank you to our media ministry under the leadership of Reverend Kimberly Meadows. Glory to God. And for our set design and our costumer, Brother Michael Williams. And to the best stage crew, Mr. Phil Everett, Mr. Tristan Ubiera, and Mr. Trevin Ubiera. And our wardrobe, Miss Sharon Lucas and Miss Cherise Denard. Y'all come on out. Let's praise God for you too. A lot happens behind the scenes. And for our co-director and other stage designer, Mr. Mark Watkins. Come on out, Mark. Praise God. And now, the woman who didn't sleep for a very long time and who is all just the ultimate cheerleader, Reverend Dr. Janet Patricia Caldwell. Give her praise. Thank you, Lord, for this leadership. One last time, let's give everybody a round of applause. Thank you all so much for coming out. Thank you, cast and crew and talented artists. Now let's welcome Reverend Dr. Dwayne T.K., the senior pastor of our congregation. Let's give Reverend Kay a hand. Let's welcome him, please. Thank you.
Come on, to God be the glory for the great things he has done. Come on, let's put our hands together and let's praise the Lord for when Jesus speaks. We praise God for TCT, for our loved ones, our young adults who put this together. Let's thank God for Taryn, Courtney, and Tracy. Come on, let's bless God for them. As if you didn't know what TCT stood for, praise God for you all. We thank God for you as well, and we bless God for the work that has been done. Today we do celebrate Resurrection Sunday, and as we celebrate Resurrection Sunday, we are celebrating gift that has been given to us. And so as we come on today, I need trustees to bring me something, because I'm talking about gift that has been given to us on this day. I want Reverend Dr. Janet Patricia Coleman Caldwell to please come and stand with me here. Because your pastor back in January told you something, and you got a look on your face at your pastor. I'm going to talk to your pastor for you, all right? I'm going to do that. I'm going to have a chat with him and all of that stuff. I'm going to talk to him soon so you know you can get ready for December the 3rd Sunday for the Word of God to be proclaimed and worship and arts. Amen. And so that'll start sometime around August. But we want to gift you today with some flowers to express love and appreciation over your passion, your commitment, your dedication, your anointing, your love for God and for God's people. It is all evident in the way that you beat that tambourine. You encourage the people of God. And so come on, First Baptist, let's thank God for the Lord's anointing. Now, on this day, we cannot gift everyone. We cannot give everyone flowers. But I want you to know that God has gifted all of us through the person and the presence of his son, Jesus Christ. We celebrate resurrection because God has gifted us life in his son. And we want to extend invitation to any person in this room who wants to respond to what God has spoken, who wants to respond to the word and the gift of God, by recognizing and knowing that if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised them from the dead, you shall be saved. This is God's gift to us. And we know that there is power when Jesus speaks. There is power in his word, so much so that a hymnologist just tried to explain what is gained when we have with Jesus, and it simply says, what a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. And the thing about praying to God is that what Jade learned is that, yes, you can talk to God, but you don't have to dominate the conversation because God wants a dialogue with you. And it is a two-way thing. It's a monologue if you just do the talking, but it's a dialogue when somebody else is talking. And don't you know the fact that God answers prayer and gives us what we need and through Jesus Christ is the Lord speaking to us. And so if you are in this place today, joining us physically or virtually, I want you to know that today is the day of salvation. Today is the day in which you can give your life to Christ, which you can make that decision to receive him into your heart. And know that wherever you go, be it Maryland, New York City, Las Vegas, or beyond these borders, that the Lord's Spirit is with you as well. So if you're here and you want to receive Christ as your Savior and your Lord, you can do it right where you are sitting. I'm going to ask everyone to please bow your head, close your eyes, and I'm going to ask those who want to receive Christ as Savior and Lord to please repeat this prayer. God, I come because I am a sinner in need of a Savior. God, please forgive me for the sins I've done against you. I admit my wrongs. And God, I am so sorry. Jesus, I believe that you are God's son, that you died for my sins, and that God raised you from the dead. I believe that you live forevermore. And Jesus, I ask for you to come into my heart and save me. God, thank you for hearing my prayer and for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. I praise God for anybody who has offered that prayer for the first time. You have accepted Christ as your Savior and as your Lord. I want to congratulate you because you are God's child. You belong to the family of God. You belong to the kingdom of God. And people who already belong to the kingdom are excited with me over the fact that you have accepted Jesus. And if you're in this room right now, I want to share more information with you. And that's why my sisters are standing to my left, because we want to encourage you in your walk and in your faith. And if you're in this room right now, I want to invite you just to come forward. They are going to take you elsewhere into the edifice and just share information with you to encourage you in your faith. If you're in this room right now and you want to become a part of the First Baptist family, I want to invite you to come as well, because we would love to have you, love to receive you. We are a church family where we love the Lord and we love each other and we celebrate God and we celebrate one another. If you're with us via our website, I want to encourage you just to check that box that you've committed your life to Jesus. We're going to reach out to you as well. And for those who are with us on Facebook, YouTube, or even on the phone, I want to encourage you to text us at 301-523-9004 or email us at fbc4009@comcast.net. Put in the message box the word SAVE, S-A-V-E, and we'll respond to you immediately. And if you're out there, you want to become a part of this church family, we are ready to receive you. We're excited about receiving you, and we want to invite you to come and just let us know that when you reach out to us, and we will share what we need to share with you. Even if it's after the benediction, you want to come and you want to respond, I want you to know that is okay, because salvation is available and today is the day of salvation. So let's put our hands together and let's praise God for those that the Lord is saving. Amen. We praise God again what we've been able to witness and share and to experience in this place on today. On last Sunday, I stood in the pulpit and I asked the congregation and challenged us and invited us to participate in sacrificial giving on today. For even as we celebrate resurrection and we celebrate what Christ has done, what happens in Scripture is that when we see that we are called to remember something, to remember the words of God, or to remember some event, or some to observe Holy Communion or what have you, the act of remembering in Scripture is not just about what we do mentally, but it's also what we do in activity. And remembering, we are actually called to respond to what we're remembering, and it's supposed to show up in our actions. It's supposed to show up in our work. And on last Sunday, we just talked about the heartache and the grief and the terrible situation that is happening in the state of Mississippi. First Baptist is a loving congregation. We believe in investing in each other and investing in people. And we've done that in our community near, and we've done it in our communities far away. We have done it beyond the United States. We have done it in the county. We have done it in the state. And now we believe the Lord is calling us to try to have an impact on those families who have suffered so much loss in the state of Mississippi because of tornadoes and because of the strong winds. And we recognize that if the wind had blown another way, it could have been our houses. It could have been our livelihoods. But we do thank God for His grace and His mercy that we've been spared, that we've been are able to share, to lend a hand, to be a blessing to others. And so I want to invite you to please participate in sacrificial giving on today. Sacrificial giving, meaning going beyond your tithe, going beyond your offering, and whatever it is that the Lord lays upon your heart to give. Please know that we are going to share this through Lock Carey. They are Lock Carey Foreign, the Baptist Foreign Mission Convention. They're sending a team to Mississippi on tomorrow to begin to look at other needs and things of that nature. And so First Baptist, we want to be able to be a leading voice even in this effort. And I'm asking this congregation for us to meet that goal of $15,000 for us to be a blessing to our brothers and sisters. in Mississippi. I'm not asking you to bring me 100. I'm not asking for folk to bring me 1,000. Whatever it is that the Lord lays upon your heart, and you're not even bringing it to me, you're bringing it to God. And please know that we are going to seek to be a blessing to brothers and sisters in Mississippi. So let us do that. Let's honor God in that. Come on, we can respond better than that. Amen. Praise God. Let's be a blessing as the Lord leads us to. So I want to invite you to do that. And also I want to just applaud and celebrate and thank God for brothers who shared on today and provided a wonderful breakfast, a wonderful meal. Let's thank God, amen, for Brother Adrian, Brother Daryl. Let's thank God for special events. Come on, if you had breakfast, you know they really did throw down. And we bless God so much for them. We thank God for what they have done and how they've used their skill to bless us. I want you to know that we actually have some food left over. It's already boxed up into go plates. And so right after the benediction, right after the amen, you're invited to go into the fellowship hall and you can grab your plate or grab your to-go box. Don't open the box to see what's in it. Don't worry, there's food in it. It's been filled up, okay? It's gonna be a blessing to you and all of that. Wanna encourage you to do that as well. And so we want to share that with you also. God has been so gracious to us, so good to us. Thank you for being with us in this place today for us to be able to worship God together. You all are so beautiful. You look good. You look wonderful. My virtual brothers and sisters, I do believe that God has graced you as well. I am imagining your smile. I'm imagining the glow on your face as you have participated with us in worship today. I pray that as we go forward in this resurrection moment, in light of resurrection, that we will live like we know resurrection happened. Yeah, First Baptist, I pray that we will live and act like resurrection took place. Because when you know that you know that you know that he got up, then you walk differently, you live differently, you talk differently, you act differently, you even breathe differently, because you have breath in your body and you know that with this breath you are called to praise God. So let us prepare to go forward in this season and in this life, acting like and knowing that resurrection happened, that resurrection took place. I want to encourage you to continue to join us in just ministry work, ministry activity, ministry partnership. Join us in worship as well. We love to have you, love to have this experience with you. We do want to make a difference in your life. We do want to make a difference in the lives that the Lord entrusts to us as well. I want to encourage your connection and all of those things with social media, but certainly as many have already been here, some have been here actually since 1 this morning. They are trying to hurry me up and get to the amen. So that's what we're going to do. Amen. I just want to sit there and remind you that your life has meaning, that you are important. We need you to survive. And so allow me just to speak this prayer over your life for this week. I pray that you will enjoy the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the grace of God, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. God bless you, family.